Hallelujah. This is one of our pastor, Archbishop. She said for 9 months she was suspended from her work because of something that she was accused of, which she could have lost her job. But she came to you and you were praying for her. She'd been putting it on the fire, putting it on the fire since. Last month, when she went for the hearing, there was no case to answer. So she won the case and she's back at work, man of God.
There was no case to answer.
Bishop, you would love to know this. You know, it's amazing. Because when I came to you, you remember I brought those letters? The way you prayed, I knew I was going to win the case. Because I've never seen you praying in tongues. I've never seen you praying for me. So that's the first day I noticed that this is done. You know, prophet of God, my RCN union who was presenting my case, you know, he was on them. Even the questions he was asking the interviewer, he couldn't answer. Because at the same time, he asked, did you find Virginia responsible for dislocating that patient? And he said, no, because there's no evidence. Bishop, they gave me time to talk. I talked. I challenged the manager, because that was a new manager. I challenged the manager. It's amazing. I've been to the center for 12 years, and I know what I've been doing. I was trained very well in my country. So I don't know what they are talking about. I've been here in the center. I've never dislocated any patient. So it must be demonic. Me, I'm a child of God. And I told them that the God I serve every week in my church will take me out of this situation. I told them.
You told them that?
Yes, I told them. I said, you are going to see. You must see God in me. I'm a child of God, and my bishop is there. Was very supportive to me. My family was supportive. My church colleagues, everybody. I didn't find any frustration in my church. I ran into the church. You know what, Bishop? The day they say, the day the manager said, "Oh, I'm suspending you." I ran, Bishop, because it was on a Thursday, I remember, and the Wednesday it was Jericho Walls. So I ran to the church and enjoyed the conference. I just laughed. They thought I was going to cry, but I just laughed. Oh, why are you smiling? Is it nice? I said, oh no, it's because I'm going to my church. I'm going to worship God.
So they suspended you and you are happy because now you're going to church.
Bishop, I went to Israel, I went to Italy, and in Italy, guess what? The woman of God was preaching, and he said, some of you are going, I have come here to come for their open doors, and my doors was open, because in a minute's time, I received a phone call saying that Virginia was were taking you back to work.
So while they suspended you, use that suspension for holiday, for God. You went to Israel, you went to Italy. Shout hallelujah. The devil meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. What can you tell somebody there right now who is watching, or somebody there? What can you tell them? When they get a bad news, or when they get bad news, what are they supposed to do?
First thing, members, you must know who you are. I know I'm Virginia. I belong to Kingdom Church. I'm under the mighty anointing, Bishop. So I knew I'm under First Lady, the anointing as well. So I know nothing will touch me. No evil will touch me. So members, don't forget to run into the church and serve God. He will do mighty things for you. Those who know God will do mighty exploits in Jesus' name. So I thank you, men of God. That's why, men of God, I've been to the ministry for 12 years. Because I know what the minister's done for me, even in my family, my children. Oh my God! I don't know, Bishop. I don't know. I don't know. I said, God, do more things in my heart, so that give me the heart of being humble in the church. I don't want to be found in any mistake whatsoever because of the anointing. I must bow down in Jesus' name. Amen.
You said something. You say that you got to give you a humble heart, not to be found in the mistakes. What can you tell those who like causing troubles? You've been here for 12 years. Yes, talk to them.
members, it depends. You know, the background counts a lot. You know that? So the way you were brought up at home, it counts because it comes out and shows up. But when you are in here, in the house of God, the man of God is teaching us, is educating us. Try to learn at least. Do you understand? When you are rude, try to learn to other people. Be humble. Those who are humble, they must be humble more. In Jesus' name. Because, listen members, my beloved sisters, brothers and sisters, you can learn a lot from a little child, even from a child from Sunday school. You can learn a lot. Do you understand? So pride doesn't count, doesn't help you as well. Be humble. Just sit at the foot. Just sit at the feet. You will see wonders, like Mary Magdalene, who sat at the feet of Jesus. But he was the one who did the most. Okay? So sit at the feet. God will raise you up in Jesus' name. Amen.
You know, she's been in this church for 12 years. Not 12 months. 12 years. But you know, the time when the rubber met the road and her career was in trouble, that is when God moved. That is when God moved. Some people serve God when everything is all right. Others run to Him when only they have trouble. But the good people, they learn. You don't allow what has come on your way to change who you are and what you do. Because you will be tested. Your faith will be tested. God will throw good things on you. He wants to see what you're gonna do. He wants to see they're gonna change you. They're gonna change what you do. And God says, I counsel that I make a short term. God throws you good things. He says, God, the more good things you give me, the more I serve you. God will allow bad things to come into your life. The more bad things that I come, the more I serve you. I am like Job. I'm not moving from my position where God is. When I was a millionaire or when I'm not, I will not allow anything. But at the end of the day, you didn't even know testimonies about her children. God has opened mighty doors. They pray professional. I mean, if she could just sit down with you and tell you the things that God has done for her, God has taken her children from nowhere into people that they can fly the flags of their country. Don't be short-sighted. But what you see now, what you see is temporary. But what you don't see is permanent. Let's say hold of that is permanent to the glory of God. Stretch your hands right now. Father, we give you the praise. Thank you for vindicating. Thank you, Lord. Your faith has made you whole.